The results are in. Tens of thousands of high school students now know how they did in NCEA after marks went live this morning. Nearly half have checked their grades with extra credits on offer for a third year to make up for any COVID disruptions. Here's Kate Nicol-Williams.
It's the school holiday reality check secondary students have been bracing for. A summer of nerves and anticipation replaced by instant relief.
Sweet.
Hawaiki Leach set his sights on an excellence endorsement. Today marks mission complete.
Taka ahuareka ana te ngākau, I te kitenga oku putanga I te rānei. I tino harikoa au narunga I te take, I tino urukaha au ki ngā whakamātautau, ki ngā mahi whānui o te kura.
A wave of emotions for this South Auckland school leaver too.
I did better than I thought.
Oh my gosh, I was a bit shocked at the same time because I was really nervous with so much exams and stuff, but I'm so happy.
Provisional data shows the number of students who pass Level 1 has dropped from before the pandemic, but NZQA points out fewer schools are offering the full Level 1 qualification. As for Level 2, achievement's also slightly down, but school leavers have bucked the trend with Level 3 results slightly higher than in 2019.
If you haven't achieved what you want to, get in touch with your school, have a conversation with them. There are things that can be done to help support you to get that extra bit of learning you need to make sure you can go where you need to go.
School leavers now have 3 years of COVID-affected study behind them. AUT started its summer program to help those considering university make the transition.
We have to remember that what these young people have been through has been extraordinary, and we should not be surprised that it may have changed what they've been able to achieve.
I know that we have to be more confident here, which really helps get me out of my comfort zone.
These students now aiming for new goals.
Very happy and very excited to be leading my kura.
Today's result a boost for some, as students hope for less disruption to their future studies. Kate Nicol-Williams, One News.